Good afternoon, ma'am.
What is your full name?
My name is Deepa Nancy Chetri, but you can call me Nancy.
Okay, where are you from?
I hail from a very small town named Halishahar, which is under 24 district Parganas.
Do you work Bengal. Or study?
At present, I'm working in a school, in a renowned school near my area. And at the same time, I'm preparing myself for my IELTS exam.
Okay, where do you live now?
I live in Halishahar, which is a very small town, and it is under 24 Pargana only. But it is not like, famous like Kolkata. But it is quite a suitable place to live in.
Okay, describe the house you live in now.
I live in an apartment. This is a four-story building. And I won't say it is too big or too small, but I think it is suitable for a small family to live together happily because it's very spacious. And yes, what we need to live in a house, we all got all amenities over there. So I'm not having any problem to live in that house.
Okay. Do you have a good view from your house?
Yes, definitely. The place where I am living, it's not like polluted or you can say congested like Kolkata. It is quite empty, but it had got lots of trees. So it's really like the landscape look very nice.
Okay. Are there any shops near your house?
Yes, we have abundant shops and all the things that we need in our daily life. It's very easily available on those shops. So I don't have to travel to Kolkata to get my things. It's really available over there.
Okay, let's talk about gift. Tell me about a gift you received that you like the most.
Who doesn't like to receive a gift? Everyone likes. But I think one gift I got it, I think 5 years back when I was doing my training during my TTC. I know at that age, receiving that gift will not be too appropriate from somebody. Like if I have to give somebody, the gift that my friend gave me won't be an appropriate gift to give her according to the age. But she gave me a box of color and she knows I'm very fond of art and craft and drawing. And that is the time when I was doing my teacher's training and that particular color really needed at that time. So I will say definitely it was looking very kiddish from her side, from other people's perspective also. But I feel this is the most important gift that at that moment of time I needed because I was doing my training. So I really was going lack of lots of color. Every day we were using color to make charts and teaching aids.
Are you good at choosing gifts?
I will say maybe or may not be, but sometimes when I look for a gift, I definitely look for the requirement at that moment, what the person likes or dislikes, and definitely the gender also matter a lot. And so I try to look for the requirement at that moment of time, that what the person need at that time. So based on that, I buy gift.
Okay. Let's talk and about yes, numbers. Are you good with numbers?
Numbers in the sense maths?
Yes.
I won't be so overconfident about it. I used to be very scared of maths when I was in school. But since I am a teacher now, so slowly when I'm teaching back those schools, those classes, so somewhere I'm able to recall myself and I'm becoming really flexible with the maths or the numbers, you can say.
Okay. Were you good at maths when you were a child?
No, I was not good at math. I really had a phobia with math. But one thing I can talk about myself that I really used to work hard a lot to solve math because I used to think why I'm not so good in math, why the other children or other students, my classmates were good in math. So that question always used to run in my mind that if others can do, why I cannot do. So maybe somewhere that focus that I can also do somewhere helped me to get the requirement marks that I'm supposed to get. I could not get 100 upon 100, but somewhere average marks, I was sufficient because as I told you that I was weak in maths, but somewhere when I worked hard, I think that paid, I can say.
Okay. Do you stay up late?
Yes, I do stay up late because I keep watching YouTube videos, especially the IELTS related videos. I keep watching them.
Okay. Why do you think staying up late is not good?
Definitely it's not good because our body needs a sufficient amount of rest in order to carry on for the next day's activities. And somewhere we should not inculcate ourselves staying awake for a late night, because definitely it gives you stress. Lots of we may think that staying awake for late night and watching videos will relax our mind, but we have a wrong concept about that. We should not be doing that thing. We should give a efficient amount of time to our brain to get relaxed so that we can carry on next day.
Okay. Do you read newspapers or magazines?
I prefer reading magazine, actually.
Why so?
Because magazine, it's somewhere easy to carry, actually. And at the same time, it has got very beautiful pictures. And somewhere pictures are able to portray the news very effectively. So somewhere I read magazines most.
What kind of news do you like to read about?
Not definitely politics, but definitely about the cricketers. And yes, something, if there's any good informative informations are there, definitely I like to read that. And sometimes I keep a note of that also. Maybe cooking, if any recipes are given in the magazine, I definitely try to look on that and try to focus on that.
Okay. Now I'm going to give you a 2-minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare on this topic, and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. My topic, describe a time when you got lost somewhere. Please say, where was it? How did you get lost? What did you do? How did you find your way back?
Can I start, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. I'm here. I would like to talk about the story of my school life. I was a member of a basketball team of my school. So our principal has chosen some of our students to go for a tournament, basketball women's tournament in Loreto House. And since there were 10 players, so we could not get into the same cap. So we divided ourselves. Five players went to another cap and we five went to another cap. So we just got into the cap, but after a while, we realized that the cab driver did not know the way, that where is Loreto House. And at the same time, when he disclosed that thing, that he doesn't know the way, how to reach there, all the students in the car, even myself, was completely flummoxed, as if we did not know what to do, because at that time, GPS was not there. We did not have that mobile phone. Those facilities, technological facilities, were not there. So we were actually lost, and we started to cry, because obviously it was our responsibility of the whole school that we are representing our whole school. So we actually could not know. Then we decided what can be done. So fortunately, we had some cops on the way. So one of the students got down, and we started to take the help from the cop to find out that how we can reach there as soon as possible, because the game was already started. And then what happened? The cop, he disclosed another thing, that we are already on the opposite side of that path. Means we already reached on other side of that Park Street. And he told us that we might take another 1 hour to reach there. So we all got so flummoxed and could not do. It was just an atrocious situation for all of us. And then we just requested the police, that if he can help us to reach those destinations. Then he told us that, okay, you all get down from that cab. He is arranging another cab, because the driver already said that he did not know where to go. Means that he did not know where was Loreto House. Then we took into another cab, and at that time, but it was really unfortunate. By the time we reached Loreto House, the game was over, and we just saw that our team was coming out of the Loreto House gate completely exhausted, because we lost the game, because these were the five players who reached before us. They were continuously playing the game, so there was not a chance for them to keep exchanging the players. So obviously we lost it, and it was a very gloomy situation for us. And now when we recall all those things, we really laugh a lot thinking of those situations, because I'm still in contact with those friends. And we really make lots of fun of that we wanted to represent our school, and this is how we lost over there. But thanks to that police inspector, he was able to help us, and he let us into the correct cab so that we can reach the destination. But anyhow, we could not play a single match on that day.
All right. Let's talk about exploring places. Why do people like visiting new places?
Actually, I think people like to visit some places because they really want to explore, they want to enhance the knowledge, the ideas, they really want to know about the cultures and traditions of that place so that they can somewhere get some knowledge and not limit their knowledge. They want to expand their knowledge.
Okay. What kind of challenges do they face?
I think language communications challenges a lot when you go to another place when they doesn't understand your mother tongue or English, which is the basic language it has become now. Definitely communication skill become a very big problem. At the same time, the temperature or you can say the weather conditions of that place become a challenging. And at the same time, I think the food also become a challenging problem because I also faced some problems when I went to Chennai because of the food problem and the language.
What kind of things should they know about before visiting a place?
I think they must know definitely the culture so that they doesn't hurt their culture. Or maybe by also sometimes it's very important to know the rules and regulations of that place because some places really have some strict stringent rules that we're supposed to follow when we're visiting to another state. And definitely a little bit of basic words so that they can communicate with the people over there and so that they can find out if they're having any problem of that field.
Do you think because of social media people are becoming very similar?
Maybe nowadays people try to adopt the culture of other countries or other states also. Sometimes we are actually doing that also. Like there was some time in past what happened, a particular place used to celebrate particular kind of cultures or traditions. But now because of this social media, we try to get united so that we can keep the peace and harmony among us by respecting each other. Because we are really coming to know lots of things from the social media. Because our knowledge also enhancing at the other time when we are focused into other things also. We are not restricted to our own cultures only or own religion status only. We really want to know the other peoples also at the same time. Somewhere the messages or the information that we get in social media really help us to respect the other cultures also.
All right. This is the end of your speaking. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank